2 minutes into this, the guy from the Drive Time Show just stopped it and was like, "Man, you're just like, you're being horrible today, and we're not going to carry on this interview. I'm not having my staff abused, blah blah." And I'm there, but you know, like, I'm like, yeah. I don't want to offend people.
This isn't
at all.
Funny anymore. Yes.
So we want to take you down memory lane. You have a look through these pics and you cool. say what you see.
Right, say what you see. Say what you see.
Me with a cello.
You had a cello. You played cello?
I played cello, yeah. I played cello. So my brother played violin and I always wanted to be my brother, but he didn't want me copying him. So I...
I love that.
I started playing cello. And I remember the day that I gave up playing cello, because I used to carry it to school.
Yeah, it's a big instrument.
And then I started
pick.
Playing guitar, so I was carrying the guitar and the cello to school. And I remember one day being like, one of these has to go. But it's a great skill to have. I mean, from playing that, I've played like the violin and cello on I See Fire. I've did like strings on Happier, and I've been able to use it on tunes.
That's
and
cool.
It's good. Yeah, it's good. I'm not like the best player, but I can get a sound out of it.
You don't look very happy in this picture. You're a bit dubious about this selection.
Oh, what, that? Yeah. I know. Well, cello.
You wanted the violin.
Mate, do you know what? I'm going to call him out now. My best friend Josh, I used to learn cello with when I was 9 or 10, and he lives next door to me, and he's my guy. And he was very cool at school, and we used to be in the football team together, and he used to call me Cello Boy, and everyone else used to call me Cello Boy. And I was kind of looking at him being like, but you play cello too. You have your lessons with me. That's how you know that I'm Cello Boy. Anyway, it turns out at school he was doing ballet the whole time.
And
if you'd have known, because he was quite a Jack the Lad, and he cello and ballet, but he kept both of them super secret.
Wow.
Actually, he learnt ballet because of this. Was it this bloke here? No, it was Michael Owen. I think was. I think Michael Owen.
Learned ballet?
I think, yeah, to do... I think it was either Michael Owen or David Beckham did it for balance, and that's why this guy did it. Anyway, this is me at the Euros with my wife, Cherry.
This was quite a moment.
David
because,
and Romeo, yeah.
Yeah, I mean, everyone else is suited and booted. They're in the Royal Box.
David Seaman. Yeah. Well, I didn't know, one, that you had to dress up for the Royal Box, or two, that I was in the Royal Box. I just knew that we were going, and we got given these tickets, and I just sort of... move along, and then suddenly I get a tap on my leg. I look around and it's David Beckham. I'm like, oh, I know someone here. This is great. And it wasn't till I was sort of looking around and I sort of turned around. David Seaman was there. I'd met him. And then I was looking forward and I saw Prince George in a suit. And I was like, I wonder why he's wearing a suit. That's probably because he's a prince. And then I looked around and I was like, oh man, everyone's wearing a suit. But no one said, I mean, what can you say? I'm going to watch England. Why?
You're there for the game.
That was a good game as well, a tense game. That was a really great game. Great fun though. Oh, and is this the first time we met?
This is the first time we met.
At the X Factor?
Yeah, in Australia.
Right.
Look at the two of us.
Kids. You know, that's crazy. Yeah, that was my song went number one off this. It was my first ever number one ever anywhere. And I played the X Factor in Australia, and literally like 4 days later it had hit the top spot. But yeah, this was that's mad.
Very special moment for
me. That was my first song,
Shape of You.
No, it was 18. This was 2011 in probably like November, I'd say.
Yeah.
Or maybe even October. But that was like I sort of found my spiritual home when I went to Australia, because all the interview, I was very like shy, coy guy in all the British interviews, and I just kind of talk like this and blah, blah. And you get to Australia and they've all got a Y on the end of the name. Everything is just, you know, it's Bitsy, you know, it's all,
Johnny.
And every single radio interview is just, there's not really anything they talk about that is off limits. So they just go wild, and suddenly your sense of humor can...
Yes,
you can get yourself in a lot of trouble.
Did you ever do radio there?
I did. Well, I used to do the show every now and then from there. But you know, Fitzy and Whippa and Kyle and all of that. I mean, you get yourself in a lot of trouble going on Australian radio.
The worst that I've ever felt was I went on the Kyle and Jackie O show, and their bit was I had headphones on and I was being interviewed by their Drive Time show, and then Kyle was telling me what to say to the Drive Time show. And 2 minutes into this, the guy from the Drive Time show just stopped it and was like, "Man, you're just..." like, you're being horrible today, and we're not going to carry on this interview. I'm not having my staff abused, blah, blah. And I'm there, but, you know, like, I'm like, yeah. I don't want to offend people.
This isn't
at all.
Funny anymore. Yeah, it's like...
and then Carl comes on going, oh, it's a joke. But this guy's like,
wasn't
no,
having it.
Yeah, it wasn't. That wasn't
no.
funny. Yeah, yeah.
DJs have huge egos. That's the problem. Huge. Yeah.
He also has a pole in his house. So there's
oh,
that.
Oh, here, Kyle. Yes. We won't talk about Kyle. Ed Sheeran, it is always a pleasure to see you. The brand new album is out now. Finally, we've waited 2, 3, 4. When was the last album out? 2.5 years, 3 years ago.
I put out a collaborations project, yeah. But this the last solo album was 2017, so four
wow.
years ago.
Well, it's been a long
and if
wait.
Anyone's listening to this and they want to check out the album, all I ask is don't shuffle, don't skip for one listen. Just listen to it in the way that I intended. I made it specifically for vinyl.
I like
there was
that.
Two okay. there was two extra tracks, and it was going to have to fit on two vinyls. So I cut off one because I love having one yeah. one vinyl that you flip over. So
and it's out on vinyl.
It's out on vinyl, yeah. And I would say that's the best way to listen to it. You can get it okay. on cassette as well, but like I just love things that you can't skip.
Mm-hmm.
You can't skip. And I'm not saying, like, once you've listened to it once and you want to pick out songs that you like and do
well,
all of that,
enough.
Create your playlist, do your shuffles, but just listen to it once.